Hello children, a very warm welcome to the virtual session again. So, we will continue with the revision of chapter 4, sorting materials into groups. So, let us see what are we going to study today. We are going to continue with a study for materials and their properties. Some properties we need to revise now. We are doing revision, so you need not write it again. If you have already written in your notebook, so it's a revision session for you to reinforce concepts. So now we are learning property of solubility. Substances can be classified on the basis of solubility. Soluble substances, under this will be some substances completely disappear or dissolve in water. So when some substances which dissolve in water, they are called as soluble substances. These substances are soluble in water, and here we have some examples like sugar and salt can be dissolved in water. So they are called as soluble substances. Here we have some substances like salt, coffee, sugar. They all will dissolve in water, therefore they are called as soluble substances. Then under the category of solubility of soluble and insoluble substances, you will have, now we are going to discuss insoluble substances. Other substances which does not mix with water and do not disappear even if we stir it for a long time, these substances are insoluble in water. After stirring also, if you try to dissolve that substance, it will not disappear. Particles will be seen in water. Such substances are called as insoluble substances. For example, stone, clothes. You wash clothes with water, but clothes will not dissolve in water. Stones, sand, chalk powder. There are many more substances which will not dissolve in water. Such substances are called as insoluble substances. Sawdust in water. You try to dissolve sawdust, it will not, even if you stir for a longer period of time, it will not dissolve at all. It will remain, the particles will be seen. So that such substances are called as insoluble substances. Next, you will see the pictures of insoluble substances. Here you have oil in water. Oil will not dissolve in water, it will show layers. So you can easily see two substances together here forming layers, and oil is insoluble in water. Similarly, sand in water, insoluble. You can see the particles of sand in water, and even if you stir, so sand will not dissolve in water. So sand is called as insoluble substance. Here oil also insoluble because it is not dissolving in water. Then you can see over here the diagram of how the substance will be soluble and insoluble, how they look. So here you can see the particles. In soluble substances, particles are equally distributed and it will not be seen with naked eyes. The substance will dissolve in a liquid. So they have shown the particles here in soluble, here in soluble substances, just a diagram to show that they are evenly distributed. But with naked eye, you will not be able to see. Like for example, sugar you dissolve in water. Once it dissolve, it will won't be seen. Sugar particles will not be seen in water. And in insoluble substances, you will see substance will not dissolve, and you will see the particles with your naked eyes. Like for example, sand in water, sawdust in water, chalk powder in water, the particles will be seen. So this is a diagrammatic representation of soluble and insoluble substances. Just need to have a look on this. Now you need to classify on the basis of buoyancy. What is buoyancy first of all? Now we will understand that. Materials can be classified based on the sinking or floating in water. So buoyancy is a property of sinking or floating in water. So over here let us see. A leaf floats on water. So you can say the property of floating, sinking is called as buoyancy. Under this, sinking or floating, we are going to learn for some objects or substances. Like metal spoon will sink in water. So that kind of, it will sink in water. Leaves and corks float in water. So buoyancy will be again divided into sinking and floating. Rocks and coins sink in water. So floating and sinking properties, you can see over here some objects will float and some will sink. Here the diagrams or the picture will show you how some objects will float. What is floating? You can see and what is sinking, it will go down below the water level, and here floating will remain on the top layer of the water. Like over here you have a cork and you have coin, so when you put in glass of water, cork will float and it will remain floating on the surface, whereas coins will go down or below. Now here come the density. Now density is defined as mass per volume. Mass per volume means the amount of a substance, how much space being occupied by the given substance. So in a suppose 10 gram of common salt occupying certain volume, that mass upon volume will become the density of common salt. So you need to understand in terms of mass and volume. How much space is occupied by a given mass is actually the density of that substance or the object. Now you can think of it as the amount of particles of a substance are packed in a certain amount of space. So there is a packing of particles of a substance into given amount of space, because when you have particles, that means it is occupying some space. Some certain amount of space will be occupied. So you have to think in that terms, this amount of particles are packed, and the packing will decide how much space it will occupy. Like for example, solids are rigids, they are tightly packed, so they will occupy a little space. Like ice, water, liquid, if you take particles are loosely packed, they are spreaded, that's why they will occupy bigger space than ice. Then water vapors in the gaseous form, they are very loosely packed, that means they are free to move, that means they can occupy larger space, larger volume. So in that terms of solid, liquid and gas, and a very simple example I have discussed with you, ice, water and water vapors. So the density will vary accordingly how much space is being occupied by the given amount of the particles. Now density, here you can see how the particles are being packed, and this diagram will show you the packing of the particles in a given substance. It can be rigidly packed or it can be loosely packed. So density of matter, how tightly packed matter is, the amount of mass in a given space. So this example, gas, liquid and solid, just now I had explained the example of ice, water and water vapors. So here this example should be clear with this diagrammatic representation, where solid are very tightly packed, they are rigid. Liquid, loosely packed or moderately packed, where gaseous, gas are very loosely packed. In fact, they are free to move, particles are free to move. So here they are shown from less dense to more dense. So gas over here will be the least dense and solid will be the most dense among all three. So now here we have to understand the concept. Here, if the particles are packed tightly together, the density would be greater than if they are loosely packed with lot of empty space around them. So density is the reason some objects sink and other float. So what is the reason behind why some objects sink and why other float? Because of the density. Example, a piece of iron is more denser than a piece of paper. Therefore, a piece of iron will sink in water, but a piece of paper will float on water. So this example should make the concept clear that why some object will float and why some will sink. Now children, after this, since we have learned density, this concept of density will be explained to you very interestingly, since we continuously I am just explaining you and you are watching the slides and you are learning the theory, it becomes monotonous. I can understand that. So now today in this session I am going to emphasize this concept with very interestingly. We will have a virtual lab where I have performed some simple experiment for you. It is very interesting to see. Please do watch the virtual lab how the concept of density will be clear with you, how the experiment is done. It's a virtual lab for you and it is very interesting. Some how it will try to make the concept clear with you all, as well as we'll try to make it more interesting so that science learning should be a fun for you children. So let us have the virtual lab where a experiment is performed for you. You just have to observe those experiments and the concept of density will be clear with you children. Thank you. Have a wonderful day and please do watch the experiment on density in virtual lab.
We learned that the objects will settle down as per their density and also as per the density of the liquids. With tiny pockets of air. When you remove the peel, you also removing those tiny air. Therefore, the peeled orange is denser and it sinks.